vague idea what we want to do. Clear the guide of what we are trying to do. So what we wanted to do was like we wanted to build a library to make it make development easy for the developer. For example, like if the developer is developing a game, that's what we tried to do. We wanted to he is developing a game, and we want to the syncing part. It's with the users, actually the players. We wanted to make it easy without the use of internet. That's what we did. We wanted to do, and we thought Wi-Fi Direct was our like it was first solution. But after actually we started searching for information about Direct Wi-Fi, but we had lots of shortcomings. For example, it only supports devices with Android version about 4.0. So it's not. What we want to do is we want to build a library with which like user can connect with other say user can connect with other users by with like you can create a group with as simple as creating an object and like create there should be a single function with which you can create a group, and other users in the network they should be able to see this user has created this group, and if he wants he can join this group. Like they can also see the other groups created by the user. Like this kind of services is already available in internet, like for example the Steam server, but we are trying to build the whole thing in decentralized way, like, without the use of internet. We want to give the users that's what we're trying to do. Like what you said yesterday with Bharti said. They just provide video streaming between browsers, right? We are trying to we have to bring whole new range for the same theme idea. That's what we're trying to do. So as I said, we still don't have any clear cut idea of how we should proceed. Now we are much more clear than how we were yesterday. What we are able to do is using Direct Wi-Fi, we were able to establish connection and like send messages, but as I said, it's not enough for what we are trying to do. So we have decided like we'll be in future we'll be doing custom coding like to facilitate the communication between the devices. It need not be Android devices. It need not be limited to the Android devices. So, with our framework, it should be possible. All the devices which support Java should be able to communicate with each other. And it need not be limited to just gaming. It should be possible, if a developer wants to create a game using our framework, we'll be providing a class for gaming. It will provide the gaming has a specific set of it has specific function calls on our way. Our library should be able to take care of them and differentiate between the applications. Like for example, we can also facilitate video calling and making calls on all across devices which support Java. So this is the basic idea I just wanted to build.
Can you use the zoom button to
zoom button of what? Projector?
The droided screen. There's a zoom button on top.
Oh,
left button.
Can you actually move it to the main screen maybe?
I'm just trying that same
thing. Oh, okay.
I'm not able to click that. If I'm just clicking it.
Let's actually go over to the full screen.
I didn't keep in the full screen actually. basic UI we just did it showcase demo. So initially the first version what we did was to set up the connection stuff, like which will take care of the connection part, how you connect to the two devices. Let's say I have my own device and he has his own device, and both of them, as of now we are using this Wi-Fi direct, and we are still in a way to find out where we can connect directly through the Wi-Fi. And okay, so from this screen you can directly enable your Wi-Fi, existing Wi-Fi. And then just switch on the Wi-Fi. And then okay, so for this demo I need two devices, like which will use this. So at least you can. So this mobile also has the same application whichever you are seeing on the screen. So I'm just clicking on the discover peers, which will actually try to discover who are the available peers. So you can see this is the device that got captured here, and when I actually try to connect to this device. From this screen, you'll get a request here to connect this request. So this is where you will actually connect to the connection part of the game comes. The whole area initially where we started is to create a multiplayer game. So everything will generalize as a common API. Like as of now, we did a lot of internal coding which will take care of the individual connection patterns and all. So what we do is like we make it like outside common classes, like common objects kind of stuff. And they can directly call this and everything will be taken care of. It's like a library, what you can see. So once we accept all these server connections, client will be able to connect. So you can see automatically updates here. So connected to the host, so that address it got connected. So that is a thing we were able to achieve within this time actually. So we still need a lot of research to be done. And because it's like we want to extend it as a general platform, we need to do a lot of research on how we can generalize it actually. Because our aim is to make it like common thing. So we are doing a lot of research actually. So we are open to have any ideas on how we can take it forward. Questions or?
Any questions?
Okay, thanks a lot.